Okay, so we want to do a little bit about the chain rule, or the chain, the chain rule here. I want to go back and remind you about composite function. So composite functions, remember, were functions that looked like f, and we had a little circle, f of g of x, which we also rewrote as f of g of x, right? And the part that I want to remind you of is all of those problems where we decomposed functions into their composite pieces. For example, find the problem went like this. Find f of x and g of x such that h of x is equal to f of g of x. This is an f. When h is this, 1 over, let's say, x squared plus 3 to the fourth power. And I talked about how in this alternative form, f of g of x is this inside piece. And we kind of looked at these functions and said, okay, well, which piece is inside? Here, it looks like this. So I let g of x be the inside piece, right? And then the outside is whatever's left. I replace this blue part with an x, and I get 1 over x to the fourth power. Okay? So do you remember that? So now we're going to talk today about how to differentiate functions h that are built like this, that have some sort of thing going on inside and then some outside piece. Okay? And to differentiate these, we need to use the chain rule. Okay, so the chain rule says something like this. Let's see. If h of x is built like this, and if it's some composite function, then h prime is f prime of g of x times g prime of x. So you take the derivative of this outside function, and then you just stick this is the original g of x, stick that back inside. And then I have then g prime of x. Okay? So let's do maybe a couple examples. Okay, so find h prime of x for h of x is equal to, and let's do this one that we just talked about up above. X squared plus 3 to the fourth power. Okay, so I identified these two pieces already, but let me write them down for you again. G of x is this inside piece, x squared plus 3, and f of x is 1 over x to the fourth power. Okay, I'm going to again differentiate these, and maybe I should write g of x over here. So let me one second. I just want to reorganize this so this looks similar. So let's put g of x over here. Because the pieces I need f prime, I need a g prime, right? So f of x, I'm going to rethink. I can take the derivative of this using just the power rule. Right? So that's negative 4x to the minus fifth power, f prime of x. Okay? And g prime of x is equal to 2x. Okay? And then I'm going to apply them here to this rule. Let me go down and we'll rewrite it with these pieces. So I have h prime of x is equal to f prime of g of x, right, times g prime of x. Okay, So I have this F prime, and I really need to stick in G prime, right? So F prime, just to be clear, F prime of G of X is what I get when I stick this G of X, X squared plus 3, into the F prime function. So I get negative 4, wherever there's an X, I put in G, X squared plus 3, to the negative fifth power. And when I simplify that, I really will get negative 4 over X squared plus 3 to the fifth, right? Okay, so that's this first part. And then I just have to multiply by G prime, which is 2x. So H prime of X back here. H prime of X is this piece, negative 4 times X squared plus 3 to the fifth times 2x. Okay, and usually people will move this and multiply it here times the numerator, so I get negative 8x over x squared plus 3 to the fifth power as the final derivative of this function. Okay, that's the chain rule. You do need to do some work decomposing and sometimes some work in plugging this back in or taking the derivative of this decomposed function, but that's what we're talking about. Okay, I want to do one more example for you guys that uses the product rule and quotient, product rule and chain rule together. So this is the example for h of x equal to x squared plus 3 cubed times 2x minus 1 to the fifth. Find h prime of x. Okay. Now, when I first look at this, the first, I guess, main thing that I see is that I do see and recognize two separate pieces that are being multiplied together. Okay? Because when it gets to the test, you will have to identify which one of these rules actually applies in each situation. So I see this as kind of the main separator here. Okay? So I think to myself, oh, that should be the product rule. Because we use the product rule when I'm multiplying things together. Okay? So let me go ahead and treat this like the product rule. For the product rule, then this f of x is equal to x squared plus 3 cubed. And then this g of x is this 2x minus 1 to the fifth. Okay? And then I really am looking at those and I'm trying to figure out how to take the derivative. And I think, well, I can't really just use the power rule. I mean, I have an exponent, so I'd like to, but there's a lot going on inside this function, right? So I have to use this power chain rule in order to differentiate this. Okay? So, let's go ahead and maybe use let's do this chain rule for f of x, and I want to try and find this. In this case, and let me just maybe name these. Let me try and write f of x as two other functions. I don't want to get confused with the naming. So let's just call them maybe u and v of x, right? And I'm thinking of v as my inside function, okay? So if that is true, this piece v of x should be right here, right? This inside piece, x squared plus 3. And then my outside piece, u of x, should be just x cubed, right? I replace this red with the third power. Okay. Oh, again, I want to rewrite this out to the side. One second. I like this kind of setup. There we go, x cubed. That's what I want it to look like. Okay, so I get u prime of x is 3x squared, right? And v prime of x is equal to 2x. Okay, so then I go ahead and use this chain rule, which should say that f prime of x, this original function, should be the outside function, its derivative of, and I plug in the original inside function and multiply by the derivative of the inside, right? Okay, take the derivative of the outside, plug in the original inside, and multiply by the derivative of the inside. Okay, so I plug this u prime of v will give me a 3. Right in here, I get the original v and squared. That is coming from right here, u prime. I get a 3 times something squared, right? And this is the something that gets plugged in, okay? And times v prime, 2x. And again, I'll probably combine these pieces, bring the 2x to the front, and get 6x times x squared plus 3 squared. Okay? Okay, that's now the derivative of f of x if we're keeping track. Okay, can you guys push pause and try and find the derivative of g of x again using this chain rule? And I'll do it here in a minute, but then like do some work and try and come back and watch and see how you're doing. Okay, now that you're back, I want to do this again. And let's write this g of x again. Let me use these u and v. So these will be different over here. I hope that makes sense. So in this case, my again v is inside. So v of x is this inside piece. I think it's 2x minus 1. And u of x is x to the fifth power. Okay? U prime 5x to the fourth. And v prime is equal to just 2. Okay? So when I take g prime of x, I get the derivative of the outside, and I plug in the original inside times the derivative of the inside. Okay? So I get this 5. Let's see, the original inside is right here, right? So that's why I'm going to plug in 2x minus 1 into the fourth. 5x to the fourth in this thing, but when I plug in that's what I get, times 2. And again, I get 10. I combine these, 2x minus 1 to the fourth. Okay, whew, that's a lot of work. And really, I still haven't used the product rule yet. So I need to do that, right? Okay, so I have this set up. I've identified my f and g, and the original product rule says something like this, right? H prime of x should be f prime g plus g prime f, right? Okay, so I plug this in, f prime 6x times x squared plus 3 squared times g 2x minus 1 to the fifth plus g prime 10 2x minus 1 to the fourth. And I have to multiply by f. X squared plus 3 cubed. Okay? Something like that. Now I'll make mention here that a lot of things, some of these will easily factor so they can be solvable. So let me take a look right here. So there is a greatest common factor here. Okay, which maybe I want to point out. For example, I can factor out. Do you see how that is common? The 2x minus 1 is common in both places. And I can factor out this one has 4 of them, and the first one has 5. I can factor out 4 of those pieces. I can also factor out 2 of these x squared plus 3 pieces. Okay, so let me try and do that, and so you can see what happens. I factor out x squared plus 3 squared and 2x minus 1 to the fourth. And I am going to show what's left, okay? What's left is 6x times 2x minus 1 plus 10 And I factored out a 2x minus 1 to the fourth, and I get left with a x squared plus 3 to the first power, right? This inside is going to easily simplify. And let's see, I'm going to go ahead and multiply this out. I get 12x squared minus 6x plus 10x squared plus 30. Keep working. These factors out here. Twelve minus 10, 2x squared, and negative 6. Oh, negative 6x plus 30. Is that what you guys get? I think if you really do want to do this correctly, there's another 2 in here that maybe can factor. I guess I'm interested to see if this trinomial will factor as well. So I'm going to pull this 2 out of here, right here, times 2 times x squared minus 3x plus 15. So I don't think the trinomial will factor. I get, like, if I'm thinking of just 5 and 3, that won't work. But this is the whole polynomial that you have in factored form. It would be easy to find zeros of this polynomial, or relatively easy, knowing what we know about them. So I just make a note that you can, in fact, factor things of this kind of format pretty easily, and we'll be needing to find zeros of derivatives in the next chapter on a regular basis. They tell kind of important things about the original function. So that's the chain rule. Let me know if you have any questions.